Ready to go?
Yes.
All right. So my name is Jasmine Alfaro. I have a podcast, friends. I have a podcast called Resiliencia. It is a made-up word. The word for resistance does not exist in the Spanish language, so being someone born and from Central America, I needed to make it up because resistance is the closest word and it's not what it is. So I work on global indigenous rights. So I work within and against organizations like the UN, like the Organization of the American States, post-secondary institutions, and I work with Black, Indigenous people of color, vulnerable people, to try and find empowerment within these spaces. So, Resiliencia is a podcast. I'm hoping it'll be about 20, 30 minutes each episode, and it'll focus on celebrating anti-colonialism. So again, really bringing Black, Indigenous people of color forward as well as allies who are really part of this conversation about really pushing the needle and helping people see a different perspective and really finding that empowerment. So that's what my podcast is about. So it'll be coming out soon.
And is your background in this area too, that you, when you said you come from Latin America?
Yeah, so I was born in Central America. I was born in El Salvador, and we came here at the very end of the 12-year civil war. So I was 4 and a half. It was a big transition for my family. I'm the baby. I have an older brother, 5 years older, and then we came with my mom. She brought us here. So we're very, very grateful that we were able to come. We were able to leave the violence that was happening, and I've just always had a connection with nature, and I, again, very privileged, very lucky to have had a chance to go to university. I started doing environmental science and really quickly learned how confused and how confusing it can be to understand our impact onto the earth. So then I started working with land protectors, people who are on the land, so learning from their stories as a researcher, and really myself kind of tunneling in and realizing that, wow, you know, communities and people who are sharing their knowledge, they're so vulnerable, and they're relying on researchers, you know, good to do people, but ultimately, who am I as a student, as an outsider of their community, to say, okay, this is what's important, and this is what I'm going to highlight for you. Because ultimately, communities get money one of three ways. Researchers who go into their communities, corporations that work with their governments, or corporations directly, or governments, and always they have knowledge and data extracted from them, and in most cases, they are exploited, because it doesn't matter the best that I can do, the Western system puts my name forward first. So what I'm about, and part of what this podcast is about, is to really bring that narrative that, you know, there are people doing amazing and exceptional things. If only they could get a platform and space to really just speak their truth, completely controlled in their own method, investors will come, volunteers will come, everything will come to them. They don't need to be excluded. So Resiliencia really focuses a very big part of that. So really focusing on the nuances.
It's 2:15. We have a hard out at 4, so if everybody could start gathering their stuff, we have to be out of here in about 13 minutes.
And how do people find your podcast once you launch it?
Currently, I think I'm most active on my Instagram, so my handle is @Aknathuram. That is also the same thing on Facebook. So Aknathuram is a non-native prairie grass, which is very dope. So it's spelled Aknathuram, Aknathuram. I also just got a Instagram handle called Resiliencia 1492. So again, sort of speaking to the fact that we are still resilient despite colonialism coming to the Americas in 1491. So that is spelled Resiliencia 1492.
Well, thanks very much for talking with us, and good luck on your podcast.
Thank you, Barry.
Thank you.